Welcome to 3 week workshop on programming in C++. In this video, I'm going to map the concept of Gentix with one simple application. First of all, what I need to do is I'm going to write one simple program for sorting the list of numbers in ascending order and to convert the program into generic data type. Means that I'm going to convert the same program which is supports for a generic. So the first thing is I'm going to write a simple logic to sort the list of numbers in ascending order by using basic concept of OOPS. I'm going to create one simple program to create it, hashing through iWorkStream.h. I'm include another one more header file. Okay, so now I'm going to create a class for testing, that is called demo applications. I'm going to create a main function. We know that here I'm going to make a sharding. So we know that whenever we're going to go with the concept of object-oriented programming, always try to, for every logic, must be write in a single separate function. I'm going to use access modifier as a probably, and I'm going to read the input first. So for that, I need a list of array elements. I need n. I'm going to get a value of c in. That means that the value of n means the number of limits I have. So enter the value of n or enter the limit. So next, I'm going to read the value of n. So now the limit, we know the limit. So that just we are going to initialize the value of array by at the time of runtime. So we know that just we are reading a value like this. So enter the value of array elements one by one. So now the input is over, then same way, but here there is a local variable we have. Don't make I as a data member. It is not the best choices because just I normally used for internal calculation purpose, so that the internal calculation purpose variable must be created as a local variable. The value of the I will not be used in anywhere, so that no need to create it like this. Means no need to create it as a instance variable, means a data member. So there is not a best choice. So just I'm going to display the value of array elements one by one. I'm going to have an output statement. The list of elements after sharding. So now it's output and as well as function. So here I'm going to write a logic for a sharding. So there are different methods we have. Just here I'm going to use a selection char for the implementation purpose. So we know that for implementation of selection char, the concept is we are going to find the element of the minimum index. So j equal to the next location itself, we are going to find the minimum index. Then after we are searching for the entire list, just we are need to compare with the minimum index with the checking element. So checking element is a or j. So if it is true, then just I'm going to store that is a minimum index. So then I'm going to swap it if the value of this I and the minimum is not equal. Logic for swapping. So t equal to a of I and a of I equal to a of min. Just I'm going to swap the value of a of min and a of I. So a of min equal to t. So now the swapping is performed. So then I'm going to close it. So here there are some of the intervals are I, j min, and also int t. So now it's okay. Now I'm going to compile, checking for is there any errors. There is a one error. So don't worry about a warning. Surely it will display errors. Yeah, there is a problem on declaration termination. I can check it. The function is closed exactly or not. So if it is closed, And sorry, still now this is a logic of for loop. I'm going to close the function also. So now I'm going to compile, but still now I didn't create any object for it. So I'm going to create a function now. So, sorry, object now. So my class name is a test p1. So now I'm going to call the method test.input for getting initialize the value of one dimensional array. Then I'm going to share the list of elements. Then I'm going to display the list of elements. So now I'm going to compile. Yes. There is an undefined symbol in which, just I need to check it. What is undefined symbol? Yeah, so here it is a local variable, so that we need to declare. So compile, no errors. I'm going to run it. I'm going to give 5. So I'm going to enter the value of this store so that the starting is performed exactly. Okay, so now we have to trace how it will work. So we know how it will work because these are the basic functions. Only we must know how this function will work. So this here I'm implementing the concept of selection set for the implementation. So that is your convenient. You have to decide what type of a sharding method we can going to use. Here there is no restriction that only we need to apply this algorithm. That's not your choice. You can follow to apply. So okay, so now the concept is over. Just I'm going to trace how this method function will execute. So automatically it get the value of n. I'm going to give my input is 6. So then that means it's going to read the values. So again, there is a problem in my input. Actually, I'm pressing some color key character so that it won't accept it. So that there is some unexpected output is possible. So I can trace once again due to this process. So I'm going to trace from starting. So you are going to read the value of input. My input is 5. Then I'm going to trace it. I'm going to read the value of n. I'm going to give 67. Then I'm going to give next input is 54. My input is 90. 34. Then 23. Then now the sharding method will be invoked. Then it will be as usual. It will be performed to find the minimum index, and it will be displayed as usual. So you know how the selection set will be worked. So that just you can use a manual calculation and test it how it will work. So the list of elements is displayed in sharding order. So once in you can check in. So the list of elements will be displayed in sharding order. So from that we can clearly understand that the list of elements will be displayed. I mean, so the working principle is correct. So that now I need to convert into the template concept. So we know that this is a template. If you want to apply the template, first of all we need to define the template. So that here only the data type of the element only will be changed. So that only one template is enough. It is always easy to understand that only the list of elements list of elements will be changed. But the size data, the integer variable may not be changed. So here just to only the two things. One is here the of n must be changed. That means the array index must be changed. Also here we need to change because the t will be stored the value of this array. Only so those data type need to be changed. The remaining and all work for the indexes so that those data types no need to change that because always the index represented by the integers. So that these are all variables which hold the integer variable, means the integers, and here also always to represent the integer because it is the total number of elements in the list. So this is a class template so that I am going to define the integer. Now I am going to compile. So there is no error. I am going to run it. So I'm going to give 3 and 4, 3, 2. So now it will be displayed as usual. So we know that if you work on instead of this integer, I'm going to say it is a float. You know that I'm telling that it is supporting for the different data types. So here I'm going to show the number of limit cannot be changed. For example, 1.3, 4.5, minus 2.3, 6.7 minus 9.8. So that the values are worked as usual things. So even if you want, you can change it as a double. If you want, you can create n number of objects for the class, and you can so you can define for a separate data type so that it works well. So as usual, I'm going to give 5. So 9, 8, 7.6, 5.43, 1.234. So it will work as usual. So that, so from that we can easy to know that. So the concept will be, the means only the small changes on this data type. Means that we are here only thing is we need to identify how many number of template we need. So here only the data type of the elements may change, but the length of the limit and the index won't change its data type. So that we need to identify for which element we need to apply the concept of a template. So here just applied the concept of template for the list of elements. So that here I applied the concept of templates, means that the class element, sorry, class template. So that we have to create, we have to define the data type of your class template at the time of creating an object. Here just, I'm just changing the data type from only one object. If you want, you can create a separate object for every data type and you can work with the same thing. Same time it will work. So we know how that object will be created for every object. But we can't use this same T1 object again for a different data type. So because we have one, at the time of object creation, the memory is fixed. So that it is a double, so that whenever the object is, even if you want, you can create a memory for a size of objects. It will be easy to understand. So that, see that here I'm going to say cout. So the size of the object equal to the size of T1. Now if you want, you can just, you can run it. So I'm going to give 5. Just to see that the size of the object is 82. So I think many of them not aware why it come for 82. Because you know, we know that only the memory allocated for local, sorry, the data members. So here only the two data members are designed. One is an integer. For integer, it is 2 bytes. So for this, it allocates it to by local variable, the memory will be allocated on one stack so that we should not collect, we should not come in, sorry, calculate it for a data member. Only we need to take on for instance variable because it is a T. So for this object, it will be considered as a double because at the time of creating object, I mean that it is a double. So that we have to say like this. So here the 10 bytes, the 10 values will be stored. Maximum the 10 values will be stored. So that in this case, it will be considered as a double. So that 10 into 8 plus 2 bytes for n. And so that 10 into 8, 80 plus 2. So 82 bytes of values will be stored because of double. In case if I'm going to make it as a float, easy, means so that only that it is a compile time replacement, so that if it is a class template will be followed, so that we need to, because we need how much amount of memory we need, so that at the time of creating object, we need to define how many memories we need to store. Means what is the data that will be stored? It is a 42, so 10 into 4 float, it is a 4 bytes, so 10 into 4, 40 plus 2, 42 bytes. If it is an integer, it allocates only the 22 bytes will be allocated. So that only at the time of compilation, we need how much amount of memory we need to allocate for that. So for that reason, always we need to define the template, I mean, so that the data type of your class template at the time of creating object. But if it is a function template, the data type of the object will be pretty clear only at the time of compilation based on the argument data type will be predicted. For class template, we need to explicitly state that this is the data type we are going to follow. So from that we are clearly understand that. So if you are going to convert any program, any specific type of program into general, so we need to understand the basic concept of generic. Then based on the basic concept, we need to identify for what type of data structure the concept of template is needed, and we need to identify what are the different possibility of a template. So for this data type, for this program, we have only one template class is possible because we need to change the data type of this element. Even if you want it, you can follow like this. That is on your choice. And class T2 like this. And for integer and all, we can say it is a T2. So here also we can mention as a T2. So, but there is no issue. But the thing is, So wherever we have int will be replaced by a t2, but whenever you are going to create an object, always the second argument must be an integer. That is the best choices. Even if you are declaring anything, it will be created an issue. So just a minute, I can check it. So I think class won't come. No, we have to define a class here. But I don't know. I think there is some. I think I did some small changes I need to do. Okay, we will discuss about it. I will discuss and tell you what is the problem I have. Yeah, sorry. I understood what the problem is. Yeah, here it is a T1. I mentioned as a TP. So that is the problem here. It is a T1 because I changed it as a T1. Now I'm going to compile. So no error. Then it will it will work as usual. But the only thing is always we need to define for it is a one-dimensional array. So that means the data type must be of your second template must be an integer. So that no need to go with this. If we know that only it is a possible on whole number, then why we need to go for a generic? So if you think that the logic is applicable for a generic, then we can work with the generic data type. But if you feel that always the data type on this category, we can work on it. But here it will not work for character. Because for a character variable, this method is not applicable. For getting an input is not applicable, but the remaining things is applicable. Because if you are, it is a character data type, I can tell you how it will work. So if it is a character data type, it won't work. The memory allocation and all okay, but the reading single value is not possible. So I think you know, because it is a string, we can read in a single line of statement. So that we can say like this, scene. Then we can go into read the value of this A. Now you can compile, no error. Then I'm going to run it. So this is a character. There is no need for a limit and all. So no problem, just I'm going to say, KRTH. It will be make it as an ascending order. Because the input way of assigning a value, the input will be changed. Because for a string, there will be initialized for only one time, means in a single line. But if you are using a 1/n node and accept like this, so that there is a problem you can fix. So that if you want to work on a character also, the short method and the display method, okay, no issue. But the thing is, and the way of initialization may be changed. But the remaining things work well. So that what I suggest to you that whenever you are going to design an algorithm, we have to identify the proper way of initializing the input. So once if you have a proper way, once you are fixing the way of proper input and initialization, then we can work based on that. So here there is no restriction that we need to follow only this procedure for initialization. That's on our choice. So even just to see that it is only allocated for 12 bytes because we are allocated memory for 10 bytes, 10 characters. So the 10 into 2, so that is 12 bytes, 10 into 2, sorry, 10, so 10 into 1, 10 plus 2, 12 bytes will be allocated. So even that is the thing I want to say that whenever you're going to create a template, we need to identify how much different characteristics possible for generics. So whenever you're going to create a generic concept, first of all, you're going to write the starting number by using your Ohm's concepts for a particular data type. So that is a very, very important. Then after identify, for a particular data type, once this particular data type works well, the logically correct. If it is logically correct, then identify the number of templates we need. Identify the number of template we need. Template needed. Then we need to specify exactly. So we need to specify according to that. Specify the template and initialize. And initialize the means the data type at the time of creating object. These are the important thing we must do over while we are going to convert a general program into generic programming. So that whenever going to write generic, always try to apply the logic only for the particular data type. Then, but for these and all, we have a one prerequisite test that is called constraint or condition. We have depth knowledge on application. So you must have a depth knowledge on application. Then only the possible way to convert your any problem into problem statement into the generic programming. For example, here I told that the value of n and all, I showed it is an integer. So because I have a depth knowledge about the programming. So if you have a depth knowledge about the application, then based on the depth knowledge, based on the our analytics, we have to identify the different type of generics. So in some cases, some data type is not applicable. So that is the way, so that we must have a depth knowledge. The based on the depth knowledge of the application domain, then we can predict it about our generic, whether we need a generic concept or maybe a specific. Based on that, we have to identify. Thank you.